Hey everybody, and welcome back to Diamonds and Denim First Impression Friday. So this one was kind of weird because I shot the tutorial part, like the test out look. I shot that Saturday, but I had a party to go to, and then I came back after the party and I tried to shoot some more, like this part and the wrap up and the swatches and all that stuff. But then I had to go to Ulta, so I didn't get to finish it. So hi, I am back again on a separate day. So this is like a 2-day First Impression Friday, but the first impression part is over anyway. But I did shoot this same look. Well, not the same look, but I shot a different look with the same palette. So this is the look I shot today. And it was using the Morphe 35F Fall into Frost palette. So this is the palette. This is the palette in the box. And I wanted to keep it in the box because I wanted to kind of show you guys a couple things. So this is the new while we're talking about packaging, let's go over packaging before we do anything else. First of all, the deal I got this at Ulta, and I think they retail for like $25, but I got it for $15. It was on sale, like right before Christmas. Like right when they started switching over to the holiday situation, this was on sale. I went in there and somebody, ladies working there, told me about it. She's like, girl, did you see the new palette? Excuse me, I'm about to go to bed. So that's how often I go, that they were like, girl, did you see the new palette? Did you get it yet? And I was like, no. I thought they were talking about one of the little smaller ones, like one of the, not Go for the Gold, like one of the bronze mocha palettes or the copper spice palettes. That's what I thought they were talking about. And then I realized it was this one. I had just said I was buying no more palettes, but I was like, that's such a big, huge, beautiful palette. I was like, I gotta go ahead and get it. So I went ahead and bought it, and I just kind of been saving it for First Impression Friday. So, but before we get started on that part, I want to go over the packaging first. So this is, so for those of us who are not, if you're not a Morphe babe like I am, I love Morphe. Like, I think for a drugstore brand, and they're considered a drugstore brand. I know that sounds crazy, but if, like, you go to Ulta, like, there's, like, the Too Faced and all those on the other side. They call those the prestige side. Then the other side is the drugstore side. That's where your L'Oreal, your NYX, your, you know, I don't know, CoverGirl and whatever. I don't put Morphe on their level. Like, I think Morphe should be a prestige brand, but it's not, thank God, because it's a lot cheaper. When you start to use them, you can see where they save money, but it ain't on the pigment, because their pigment is amazing. Like, look at this eye look. Again, that was straight. I didn't add anything. That is straight up, except for liner and lashes, but all the eyeshadow is straight up this Morphe palette, Fall into Frost. So, again, if you're a Morphe babe from a while back, again, like I am, this is the new packaging, which I like it better. This is the old packaging. So the old packaging to me looked a little cheaper. It came in boxes, which is nice because a lot of drugstore brands don't come in boxes. But if you just look at them together, this one clearly looks more professional. It's got the model number, it's got the name of it and all of that. This one literally just has that. Now, I was gonna say on the back it's on there, but it's not even on the back on this one. It's nowhere but on the actual palette itself, but we'll talk about that later. So this is the old packaging. This is the new packaging. Let's take it out. Oh, and look at this. You see how it's red on the side and it says blend the rules? I like that. And then on this side, again, you have 35F Fall into Frost. So if I was keeping them in the boxes in a drawer, you could stand them up and just kind of flip through them almost like library books and find the one you're looking for. So let's take a look at this one. On the back, it says, okay, so even this. This is what it says on the back. This is what it says on the back here. It's just the ingredients. On the back here, it says 35 shades to change your world. Meet your squad of beyond creamy, highly pigmented, super blendable eyeshadows. The Shimmer Winter palette is bursting with 28 frosty shades and 7 matte transition wonders. The endless plum looks are up to you. Morphe babes don't just blend in, they blend the rules. So, I really like that because when I opened it, that was one thing I noticed instantly, that there were so many shimmer shades. And there's like maybe, well, they said it on the back, there's 7 matte transition wonders and the rest are shimmer. And I usually don't like a lot of shimmer. Y'all know I like a lot of matte because I usually do, like I'll do a shimmer eye and a matte lip, or I'll do a glossy lip and a matte eye. That's what I usually go for, but you know. So let's open it up. So this is the new palette. This is what the new palette looks like. The new outside of the palette. This is the front. This is the back. I mean, this is the old palette. So this is what the old palettes look like. And I'm not just crazy. I don't just keep these like to keep them. I actually keep them because when I travel, they're so big. When a palette is this big and wide, it's easy for them to break. So I keep the boxes like for when I travel. So just a heads up. So these are the palettes themselves, the comparisons. Again, I think personally, this one looks much more professional. It's just a lot cleaner. I just really like it. And then on the back, you had the little dots on the back that told you which one it was. Like this one is the 350M, which is the Nature Glow Matte Palette. And then this one says 35F but it also has on the back Fall into Frost. So I just like that a lot. Let's see what they look like on the inside. Oh, okay, so there's differences on the inside too. So this one, I remember when I bought it because it still has it in it. Oh my God, I'm such a hoarder. So if you look at these two, the top of this one, the top of the new one says Morphe Babe. Hashtag Morphe Babe with the M on it. This one on the top has nothing. It is literally just blank. And another thing, the plastic cover that's on it, these have names on them. So each one of them has a name on the cover. This one is, again, just blank. So I just went, when I was doing my first impressions on it, and every time I use it, if I'm doing a tutorial with it, because I use Morphe palettes a lot. And if I'm using like if I'm using the older Morphe palettes, I would just have to say like the third one in the third row to the left. So with this one, I could actually say the names. It's a little difficult because the names aren't printed on it. It's on the plastic thing. So when I take the plastic thing off, you know, I couldn't see it. But again, the new Morphe palette I have here, I want to kind of just show it to y'all real quick before I start the demo. So here's the palette itself. I don't know that this really makes a difference, but I'll move it anyway. So again, I don't usually like a shimmer palette, but y'all, I mean, these shimmers are so shimmery. Like, they are insane. They are so gorgeous. But y'all see that when we swatch them. Should I swatch them first? Let me swatch them first, actually, before we do our tutorial. So now, while I'm rolling up my sleeves here, literally, I'm not going to do all of them. Because, of course, Morphe has 35 freaking shades. I don't have all day to sit here and swatch. So I'm going to pick, like, kind of the ones I like the most and the ones I use the most. And I'm going to put those on my wrist just so y'all can see. So let's say three mattes and three shimmers. Let's look at them. So I'll pick three of the shimmers first. Let's go with, okay, Visible is like the bomb. So I'll do Visible, which is this first kind of shimmery shade. So Visible. Let's do Visible. Let's do Belladonna. Which one is Belladonna? I love Belladonna. And let's go with whatever this gold one is, Belladonna. Cairo. Let's go with Graphite because Graphite looks bomb. So this one is Visible. Yeah, you see what I'm saying. This one is Belladonna. I mean, and this one is Graphite. Can I just say again so that y'all can hear me and understand that this palette was $15 and there are 35 shades and most of them look like this? I mean, can you complain? If you can, you have a problem. And then let me take three of the other ones. Let's use let's use Bliss, Obsidian, which is the black one I used in my tear duct, and Fortune. I mean, in my tear duct and my V. So this one is Bliss. The mattes aren't as good. They're a little chalkier than the, yeah, you can't even see it. Obsidian. Okay, yeah, so the mattes aren't quite as good as the shimmers, but I mean, come on, get it together. And then last but not least, this one is Fortune. So those are our swatches. Again, we have Bliss, Visible, Belladonna, and Graphite. Then we have Bliss, Obsidian, and Fortune. So these are our swatches. Again, I only did 6 of them. Just I don't want to do 35 of them. So I'm going to pass you along now to what I shot Saturday, the actual tutorial. But just another reminder, this is the same palette. The palette is the same. I just did a different look because I got a chance to do. And I don't usually get to do 2 different looks. So, you know, I'm down for that. So let's go to the tutorial. Okay, y'all. So just like every other time, I am primed and sprayed and eyebrows are done, obviously. Got concealer around them. It's still a little halo around it. Not mad at that. Gonna take care of that when we do our foundation and whatnot. So let's open. This is like my real first time ever opening this package. I know we talked about the packaging already from earlier when I looked at the old one and the new one, but let's open it for the first time ever. I love the new boxes Morphe has. It looks so much more professional. Ooh, it's sliding out the bubble wrap. Ooh, beautiful. So much better than they used. I mean, they weren't hideous the way they used to be, but you could tell where they save money. This looks so professional. I live for it. Okay, put the box down for a minute. Let's open it up. Oh! Still no mirror Morphe, but that's okay. I understand. We got to save money. That's fine. I'm not mad at that. So here's the inside of it. They have names for all the shades now, which is kind of cool. But the names are on the paper, on the little plastic thing, so I can't really go over it with y'all one at a time. I like the new Morphe Babe thing. looks gorgeous. The palette is beautiful too. So it's a lot, it's way more shimmers than I'm used to in a palette though. Like they have, if you look here, there's literally one row of mattes down at the bottom and then everything else is shimmer. And this is the Fall and a Frost palette, so I guess that makes sense. Let me see something real quick to see if I can talk to y'all about the shades as I'm working. Yeah, I think I can make it work. So let's go ahead and get started. Oh, this is gonna be difficult. It's just so many shimmers. Like I said, I'm just not really used to that many shimmers. Y'all know I like a good matte eye, but okay. So just like every other First Impression Fridays that involve eyeshadow palettes, I'm gonna start with my Bogache brush, the smudge brush. And I'm gonna be honest with y'all, just like every First Impression Fridays with eyeshadow palettes, I have absolutely no plan of what I'm doing. So bear with me. I'm gonna zoom y'all in and we'll do, which eyebrow looks better? That's how I usually figure this out. We'll do this eye together and then I'll do this one off camera. So let me zoom in. Ooh, child. Okay, oh my God, I hate doing this with no other makeup on because it just looks so bad, but I always do my eyeshadow first, so why lie to you guys? So I'm gonna start with Bliss, which is the lightest matte shade right here. I'm gonna go ahead and use that as my all-over base. Big Bogache brush, and again, I'm going from lid, lash to brow with it. Okay, next for our transition color, I'm going to go ahead and go in with, I kind of like Fortune right here, this like kind of reddish brown color. Another matte, of course. Again, I try to keep things very matte. Oh, that's darker than I was expecting it to be. These colors are really pigmented. But Morphe's always really pigmented, honestly. Like, I don't have a Morphe palette that I can't see what I'm doing with. Like, they're all super pigmented. And by the way, Morphe is, like, just a, I mean, I don't want to call it a drugstore brand, but, like, it's not, like, at Ulta, it's not a prestige brand. It's over, like, by the NYX and stuff. Like, I don't know. Morphe is, like, insane. I love Morphe. Because, like, this Morphe palette is more pigmented. Every Morphe palette I have, actually, is more pigmented than, like, my Urban Decay Naked palette. All right, so we have our base and our transition color. Now I'm going to go ahead and give myself a crease color. This palette is bananas. Like, I have no idea. Okie dokie. Also, that's also my party I'm going to is also the reason why I'm dressed like a nomad. Or the, I forgot their names. The guys that would bark in Black Panther, that's the reason I'm dressed like this. It's not just because I feel like doing it. So for my crease color, I'm gonna go in with, they're all so freaking shimmery. Like, I don't know. Okay, so for my crease color, I'm gonna go in with Vienna, which is this pretty, like, kind of khaki brown color. So Vienna, SL Miss Glam crease brush. Let's see what we got. I have to be really light-handed with this because it's, like, really pigmented. Oh, it's pretty, though. Oh, it's not as shimmery on the eye as it is in the pan, thankfully. It's just so not my vibe. Super shimmery is not really my style. I mean, jewelry and clothes, yes, but not with the eye. I like a good matte eye, but anyway. So that's good for the crease. That's what we'll do for the crease color. Okay, so around my eye is pretty much done, so I'm going to blend that out really quickly. Y'all, this palette, I mean, it's really good. It's just very shimmery, but it's really pretty. Like, the colors are so pigmented. Okay, okie dokie, people. So I have a Glamour Dolls brush that I'm going to use just to blend out all of this look so far. It's like a sunrise, so pretty. Okay, so now that we're all blended, I'm gonna go and do my milk off camera and carve out my lid, and then I'm gonna come back and we're gonna do this real pretty purple look. It's my plan, as much of a plan as I ever have, so. All right, so back with my eyes carved, my eyelids carved out. So now I want to do something I never do, but I'm gonna do it today. Because again, this is just such a pretty palette. So there's so many different reds, and actually I'm wearing a red shirt today. I don't ever match my shirt to my, I don't usually match my eyeshadow to my clothes, but since there's so many, I mean, with Reduce and Magician and Belladonna and Cabernet and Ariel, I feel like a purple warm kind of look is obvious with this palette. So I'm going to go in with Cabernet. Cabernet is going to be my main lid color. Then on the inside of Cabernet, I'm going to do, let's just start with Cabernet because I'm doing too much. Belladonna is actually really pretty too. Cabernet is the second to last one. So Cabernet, let's see what's up. with Cabernet. I should have did a darker base if I was gonna use Cabernet, but I didn't think about it. Oh, it's a lot lighter than I was expecting it to be. But again, that could be the milk base instead of having like a black base. Like a black base probably would have made it more like a wine color instead of this like almost lavendery color. Oh, it's pretty though, y'all. Now that I got it at the, I don't want to say consistency, but you know what I mean, not consistency. The shade I wanted. That's a color, like I never do that color. All my looks are like usually gold, but this is pretty. Okay, so Cabernet is on both eyes now. I have just this little inner corner. So now I just have this little inner corner left that's white on the inside. And what I'm going to do for that, actually I wanted to do an all ready look, but maybe I'll do under eye red. I like some of the golds they have in here. So I really wanna try. Let's go with chiffon. So chiffon is this really pretty gold color right here. And I'm gonna use that for my inner eye corner because it's just, like I said before, it's just so pretty. Okay, so chiffon, inner corner for chiffon. Oh my gosh. Chiffon is so pretty. I would almost venture to use it as like a blinding highlight. It's so pretty. I'm sorry, I'm looking over there because I can't see my eyeshadow in this corner. In this camera area right here. So I'm looking over here to see the look, but I have to look back there so that I don't look crazy talking to y'all. So go grab a blender to blend this all together because I hate lines of demarcation on my eyes because I'm not crazy. Well, I am crazy, but not, you know, about that. Before I go and switch out, I'm gonna go with Visible, which is this really pretty like pearlescent white color all the way at the end. I'm gonna go with Visible and just highlight my brow bone because I just think it's such a pretty color. Yeah, so see what I was saying about it maybe being a blinding highlight like that? That's gorgeous. Let's blend out the lid and then I'm gonna go in and do my dot my V. Oh, this is a SL Ms. Graham blending beauty brush. And I'm just using that in order to blend out the little line of demarcation between that gold and that purple. So yeah, this palette. Okay, Morphe, I see you Morphe again. For my V, I'm gonna go in with Intuition, which is this kind of deep raisin purple right here. So that's gonna be my V color today. And I'm going to take my contouring eyeshadow brush from Shani, and I'm gonna just dot that V real, real quick. This color is not as dark as I was expecting it to be. That one is not as pigmented as the rest of them. It looks like I got a good bit on the brush, right? So let's see, let's try again. Right. Yeah. It's a little bit of a letdown. But maybe it saved me from myself, because again, I didn't want a super smoky. Okay, so now it's time to do a big blend out. Okay, so the all-time fave, Elizabeth Mott blending brush, the big one, this one, just to blend everything all together. Because the only time I don't do a big blend like this is when I'm doing a cut crease, and today I'm not doing a cut crease, so. Okay, anyway, so I'm gonna blend everything out. I don't like all that puzzle face, you know, especially if I'm not doing it for a look, like I said, like I do with a cut crease. What did I think about the look? It came out pretty good, right? Yeah, just the look itself, like the overall look. This is the overall look of the eyeshadow. I'm gonna do an under eye thing, and then I'm gonna actually try two eyeliners. Then I'm gonna go off camera, do the rest of my face, and I'll come back to decide if we're giving it a diamond or not. So let's do our little bonus products. Okay, so the two bonus products I have are actually two eyeliners, which makes sense that I'm using them now to try them out now. Just two free redemptions I got at Ulta. So I just wanted to test them out. Since I'm already doing a new eye look, I'm gonna go ahead and just do an all new eye look. So this is the Clinique Pretty Easy Liquid Eyelining Pen. And I also have the Julep When Pencil Met Gel Long Lasting Eyeliner. That's cute. I'm gonna use this one. So this is the Julep one. It's like a gel eyeliner. So I'm gonna use it as to tight line. No, I'm gonna save the Julep one for after I do my lashes and everything, because after you curl your lashes, sometimes that fleshy part shows. So I'll wait for that one. But as far as this Clinique one goes, I'm gonna do that, then my under eye, and then I'll go finish my look. So I see. Okay, so Clinique, I'm gonna like do First Impression Fridays and a First Impression Fridays. This is the packaging for this one. It's Clinique, black and white, simple. Clinique is very simplistic. I got this one in the shade black. Again, it was an Ulta redemption, so I don't always get exactly what I want. Oh, that's a redemption? That's a big redemption, y'all. That's like a full-size eyeliner. Good times. Okay, I'm not mad at it. So, again, this is the box, just a package. Black on the top, so on and so forth. And then we got Clinique Pretty Easy Liquid Eyelining Pen. I love how Clinique stuff is, like, it's so, you could tell it's high and you could tell it's Clinique. See how this, the letters are, like, foiled? Then they have black on the back, pretty black pen. I wonder, I haven't seen them, but I wonder if they're all, like, if they're all, like, the same color. Like, if they're all black or if the color of the tube is the color of the liner. I don't know. I'd have to check. I'm going to look that up later on. So, I'm going to do what I always do with liquid liners. Y'all know. Ooh, this is nice. Okay, it's not a marker. It's like a little tiny, teeny tiny little hair. It's like a paintbrush almost. Like, ooh, this is, okay. Not mad at it. That surprised me because I thought it was just going to be another marker liner. It's not. It's like, you can't see it on camera because it's just so small, but it's got little tiny bristles on it. Like I said, just like a paintbrush. So let's see what it's got. I tested it on my hand a little bit, a little tiny swatch. I always do that with liner because I don't want to wait till the last minute and then check it and be like, oh, wait a minute, it draws a whole different way than I was expecting it to. So, draws pretty good. All right, let's see what's up. So just like always, I am building it up. Cause especially when you're using an eyeliner for the first time, you don't wanna just do a big old swatch if you don't know how it's gonna work. Cause that could really ruin your whole eye look. So this is pretty though, I like it. It's so easy to glide on. And it's a matte black, it's not like a shiny black. Like sometimes I'm in the mood for a shiny black liner and sometimes I'm in the mood for a matte eyeliner. Oh, God dog it. Have to conceal that away. Okay, I like it. Do the other eye, and I'll just attach this diamond thing to the end if I'm giving it a diamond or not. I'm pretty sure. I mean, it's a liquid liner. I don't know how much, you know, how much fanfare there can be around a liquid eyeliner, or how wrong it could be a liquid eyeliner. So, do the other eye. Okay, so now that my liner is done on both sides and all of that, I'm gonna go back in with. Is Belladonna the color I did on my leg? Oh, no, I did. Yeah, okay, I wanted to do Belladonna. So I'm going to go in with Belladonna right here, and that's going to be my under eye color for today. Belladonna. And Belladonna is kind of like, it looks like it's like Cabernet, but it's a little bit lighter, and there's a little more like brown in it or a little more gold in it. So with a Vasanti pointed brush, angled brush, whatever. No, Vasanti contour eyeshadow 4 brush. I'm just going to go underneath. Yeah, it's pretty. And then I'm gonna go back in with chiffon again, which is the color I did on the inside. I'm just gonna kind of tear duck it a little bit because it's just so pretty. My eye look for the Morphe Fall into Frost palette is pretty much finished. I have one more little thing to try at the end, but I'll do that later. So I'm gonna sign off now and go and do the rest of my face, and I'll be back and we can decide if we are giving this look a diamond or not. So I'll be back. Okay guys, so I'm back and this is the finished look using the Morphe palette. Well, almost. I have one more thing to do. I have another thing to try out. So this Julep When Pencil Met Gel Long Lasting Eyeliner. So this is another sample I got from Ulta. It was a redemption. So any purchase, you got this free. They sent a little coupon to your email. It says on here, glides on with no tugging, stays put for 10 hours, when pencil matte gel available in black is black, smoky taupe shimmer, and they have all the shades in here. So this was the little package it came in. This is the Julep. This is the inside, here's the outside. This is the actual little liner itself. It's cute. Julep When Pencil Matte Gel Long Lasting Eyeliner. So this is it, and they gave me the shade Black is Black, which is awesome because y'all know that's the shade I would use. So what I'm going to do with this today is I'm going to underline my eyes with it just a little bit, not that much, and also I'm going to tight line with it. So let's check it out. Whoop. Okay, first of all, the point on the top is like bananas. Like, I love that point. So I'm going to have to do with y'all because, again, tight lining and whatnot. So all I do when I tight line is I just close my eyes on it, and then I just drag it across. What did I do by here? Is there like an eye hole? What is that about? Huh. Okay, well. Ooh, I like the tight line. The tight line came out very good. Okay, Julep. weird. So, and I'm gonna just do the corner real quick just to connect that black. Oh, it's so dark. I love it. Okay, this right here is the finished look. So it looks good. I love everything that's on there. So let me go grab all the rest of the stuff and we'll decide if I'm giving it a diamond or not. Okay, people, so I am finally finished with all of the reviews for today. So we need to decide if we are giving these diamonds or not. So first of all, this is the finished look using the Morphe Fall in a Frost palette, the Clinique, the new Clinique eyeliner. I don't remember what it's called, so I'm gonna go over one at a time in a second. So first, the last thing I tried out, the Julep When Pencil Met Gel long-lasting eyeliner, the little redemption I got from Ulta. This one, I like it a lot. I would give this one a diamond for sure. It's pretty pigmented. It helped me tight line really easily underneath, and I love a good straight up black gel eyeliner. This one glided on, no tugging, no nothing. So love this one. This one, the Clinique Pretty Easy Liquid Eyeliner Pen. The tip of the pen is so different from anything I've ever used, but it's so pigmented. It was really easy to use. It wasn't as easy as some of the other ones because, like, I messed up right here. I usually never mess up on a liquid eyeliner, but it was pretty good. So, I mean, liquid eyeliners, it's hard enough for eyeliners to get a diamond because, like, what are you going to do to mess it up? So these both will get a diamond. And now the main attraction, the Morphe Fall in a Frost palette. So do I think this palette deserves a diamond or not? Look at my eyes. Yes, obviously. So in keeping with the rest of the Morphe family that I own, for sure it gets a diamond. I mean, Morphe just, like, does not miss. Like, I don't know what the deal is, but Morphe just, every single one is a hit. Every palette I have is beautiful. And let me tell you, when I first opened this one, when I got home, I was like, is it too late to return it? There's so many shimmers, and I don't like shimmers. Usually I'll do, the most I can do with shimmers is usually a good half and half palette. Like, you know, give me 24 pans, 12 shimmers, 12 mattes. But this many shimmers and so little mattes, usually that's not my vibe. But y'all, this palette, I mean, the first time, look at this, look at that. I mean, the last time I had a palette I liked that much was the original Tarte Lip palette, which was all mattes. So that says a lot. So this Morphe Fall into Frost 35F palette, $15 at Ulta, definitely gets a diamond. Thank you so much for watching First Impression Fridays. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I help you make a purchasing decision. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave it down in the comment section below. Please go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Maybe even, I don't know, maybe like this video if you feel like it. Check out the corresponding blog, which I will link down below. I'll also link the other Morphe palettes that I've used. I'll link those down below too, so you can check those out too. Other than that, anything else you need, you can hit me up on the social media slide, which is always the final slide of the video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.